What's good, guys? So it will be July the 5th, 2020, before this video comes out. Something that's always bothered me about the Kenneka Jenkins case is that the phone dumps were so vague. They were incomplete. They had very little data. And I know I keep going back to this, but the GPS was never included with it. And I just don't feel like they're being very transparent about the phone dumps of the phones that they did. So I've been doing a lot of research on these phone dumps. Aside from what I already learned in my degree path, I've done a lot of research on this subject. So this is just, hold on, let me pull up something else. Okay, this is what I was looking for. This sums it up pretty good. There are three generic types of extraction on a cell phone: logical, file system, and physical, which provide a framework to consider extraction technologies. No one technology can access and extract all data from all phones. And no one type of extraction is guaranteed to be successful. Alright, so with that being said, let's look at something else. Okay, so what I wanted to see was what an actual phone extraction looked like. A phone extraction report, should I say. So I found this article on ZDNet.com. And it says, leaked files show what a Cellebrite phone extraction report looks like. And then it says, U.S. law enforcement alone have spent millions on the phone cracking technology. And I'm really happy that I found this because it's actually from 2016. So it's a good base because this happened in September of 2017. So technology probably went a little bit further than what this report said. But regardless, alright, it says, earlier this year we were sent a series of large encrypted files purportedly belonging to a U.S. police department as a result of a leak at a law firm which was insecurely synchronizing its backup systems across the internet without a password. Among the files was a series of phone dumps created by the police department with specialist equipment, which was created by Cellebrite, an Israeli firm that provides phone cracking technology. The digital forensics firm specializes in helping police collar the bad guys with its array of technologies. It shot to fame earlier this year when it was wrongly pinned as a company that helped to unlock the San Bernardino shooter's iPhone, the same phone that embroiled Apple in a legal brouhaha with the FBI. Alright. It says Cellebrite's work is largely secret, and the company balances on a fine line between disclosing its capabilities to drum up business and ensuring that only the, quote, good guys, end quote, have access to its technology. So, I was really interested to see what this report shows because, I know what the report shows in the Kenneka Jenkins file, and it doesn't show much. What, I think we got a few text messages, a couple of little video components, really nothing. All right. Now, it says, and this is a company that's commonly used. I want to make sure that's stressed. Cellebrite is a company that's commonly used to do phone dumps. All right. It says, the forensic company claims it can download almost every shred of data from almost any device on behalf of police intelligence agencies in over 100 countries. It does that by taking a seized phone from the police, then plugging it in and extracting messages, phone calls, voicemails, images, and more from the device using its own proprietary technology. It then generates an extraction report, allowing investigators to see at a glance where a person was, who they were talking to, and when. And that is what I want in this case. And that is what we should have, to be quite honest. All right. So it says, we obtained a number of these so-called extraction reports. One of the more interesting reports by far was from an Apple iPhone 5 running iOS 8. The phone's owner didn't use a passcode, meaning the phone was entirely unencrypted. It says, here's everything that was stored on that iPhone 5, including some deleted content. All right. And I'm going to blow this up. Hold on. Okay, so I blew this up because this is what their report should look like if you're using the Cellebrite system. And mind you, there are only a handful of companies that do this. And, I mean, I could run down the gamut of them right now. And we could probably go over each one of those. And we would have even more questions as to why we don't have any more data. All right, so here's the things that it pulls up. Calendar, call log, chats, contacts, cookies, installed applications, locations, MMS messages, notes, SMS messages, timeline, user accounts, voicemail, web bookmarks, wireless networks, data files. And then underneath that it says audio, configurations, databases, images, text, videos, activity analytics, and analytics phones. So, then the next column, it says included in report. And it goes through and lists how many of those it has. And then in red, it shows how many were deleted on the phone. Because, you know, you can delete it, but it's still lingering on that phone. So, for example, let's see. On the contacts, it shows 111 included in the report with one deleted. Cookies, 1,061 with 21 deleted. All right. So that's just a sample of what that software company can do. Now, back to this article. It says the phone was plugged into a Cellebrite UFED device, which in this case was a dedicated computer in the police department. The police officer carried out a logical extraction. Remember, there are three types, which downloads what's in the phone's memory at the time. And then in parentheses, this motherboard has more on how Cellebrite's extraction process works. Well, we don't know what process they used. That's for starters. In some cases, it also contained data the user had recently deleted. That's what we just saw. To our knowledge, there are a few sample reports out there floating on the web, but it's rare to see a real-world example of how much data can be siphoned off from a fairly modern device. Then it says, we're publishing some snippets from the report with sensitive or identifiable information redacted. Cool. I'm cool with that. So here's an extraction report. And I am going to... It won't let me zoom in, so hold on. Let me take a snapshot of it. Alright, so looking at this extraction report, this of course is for the Apple iPhone that we were just speaking about. And it's the logical method, using the logical method. All right, it's got summary. It shows the connection type, the extraction start date and time, the extraction end date and time, the extraction type, the UFED physical analyzer version, which is 3.9.8.7, the time zone settings, case number, evidence number, examiner's name, department, and location. We don't have that. See, the thing is, we don't have anything from the Arlington Heights Police Department besides the little slip of paper. And it's funny because Chloe had done a video on this very similar thing along the same lines, anyways. And I was working on this at the same time. We must have been thinking about the exact same thing. Because again, I was going listening to the narratives and I'm like, something's not adding up here. But I couldn't put my finger on it. So, anywho. Yeah, we don't have a report like this from Arlington Heights, from Detective Gasick. We don't have that. Now, I know he's qualified to do one because I looked up his qualifications. So, where is the information? All right, then it goes into the device information. And I screenshotted it and we're going to zoom in on it. It says the name, it shows the Apple ID, and it's got an email address out beside of it in the value column. Device name, which you name your own device. And if you don't, I think it just throws something generic in there. Display name, ICCID, the IMEI. Then it says is encrypted, and it says false. They've already told us that it is not encrypted. The last activation time. See, these things would have been extremely useful to know. Last used, ICCID. Phone number, product type, iPhone 5, product version. It's already said it's running iOS 8. Serial number, unique identifier. So we don't have any of that. And yes, I mean, there are things that are going to have to be redacted, just like the police reports, just like everything else in the file. So why not include this? Then it says image hash details. No reference hash information is available for this project. And then underneath it says file dump. Path, iPhone backup.tar, size, and it's got a value there. The next portion says extraction software plugins. It's got the plugins listed. And it's got the authors and the versions. So this one specifically lists 8 plugins. The iPhone backup parser, the CPIO extractor, the iPhone databases logical, the iPhone device info, QuickTime metadata, analytics, contacts cross-reference, and the data files handler. And then it goes on to tell you what each of those are. The iPhone backup parser parses all iPhones backup slash logical slash FS dumps, including decryption and or file system creation when necessary. The CPIO extractor decode all the CPIO files in the extraction. Excuse me. The iPhone database is logical. It says it reads various databases on the iPhone containing notes, calendar, locations, Safari bookmarks, cookies and history, Facebook friends, and Bluetooth pairings. iPhone device info decodes device information for iPhone devices. QuickTime metadata extracts metadata from Apple QuickTime movies. Analytics generates the analytics section information. Contacts cross-reference. Cross-references the phone numbers in a device's contacts with the numbers in SMS messages and calls. We'll fill in the name field of calls an SMS if there's a match. Now that would be really handy to have, because I know a lot of folks that try to be slick with it. Data files handler tags data files according to extensions and file signatures. Extremely handy to have. And this is what I would have loved to have had. This would have shut me up right here. The locations. It shows it on a map. It says the extraction software records the geolocation of every photo that's been taken and visualizes it on a map, allowing the investigator to see everywhere the phone owner has been and when. How handy would that have been? How handy would that have been in this case? Now, it gets into the messages. And again, I did a screenshot just so we can zoom in. It's got a, the top of it says participants. It's got the numbers. Then it says the start time and the last activity. Then it lists the body. Shows the from, and then the red is the name that matches that contact. Now see, the next number doesn't have a name listed. So that means it's not in the phone. Then it's got the time and body. The attachment on that one there. That's about the closest that we've got. This is all we got. You know how many times these kids get on these phones? And you're telling me this is all we got? I'm not going for it. I'm not buying it. So see, they redacted the numbers. Excuse me. This is stuff we could have got. They could have just redacted it. Then it goes into the user accounts. It says, user accounts. This portion reveals the phone owner's user accounts on the phone depending on how many apps are installed. In this case, only a username and password for Instagram was collected. How handy would that have been? So you wouldn't have had to fool with none of that. They wouldn't have had to have asked them nothing if they had collected those phones. They would have had it all in a report. Then they could have went and looked at it themselves if that's what they wanted to do. Alright, then it shows the wireless networks that it was connected to, that the phone had been connected to. It says wireless networks. The extraction software will download a list of all the wireless networks that the phone connected to, including their encryption type and the MAC address of the network's router and when the phone last connected to the network. Call log. The report contains a full list of call records, including the kind of call, incoming or outgoing, the time, date, and phone number of the call, and duration of the call. This type of information is highly useful when collected by intelligence agencies. I'm telling you, you know, it's, I hate to say this, but I'm going to say it anyways. It's complete bullshit that they put these files out there anyways. Who does that? Oh, you're really being cooperative. You're really trying to show that you're transparent, yet you're still hiding information. They are still hiding information while trying to appear like they're being Mr. Nice Guy and Mr. Look, we have nothing to hide. Here's all the files. And that's not the case. That's just not the case. We don't have everything. And that's the stuff that pisses me off. Contacts. It shows the contacts. All nice, neat, and organized. It says contacts in the phone are vacuumed up by the extraction software, including names, phone numbers, and other contact information, such as email addresses. Even deleted content may still be collected. Goes on to show the installed apps on the phone. It says all of the installed apps, their version and permission settings are recorded by the extraction software. All of the notes. Any data written in the notes app is downloaded too. Here we have redacted what appears to be bank account information. Voicemail stored on the phone are collectible and downloaded as audio files. It also includes the phone number of the person who left the voicemail and the duration. And this one's showing 81 voicemails. Then it shows the configurations and databases. It says property list or plist, store app data on iPhones. These individual files contain a wealth of information such as configurations, settings, options, and other cache files. Activity analytics for each phone number. The analytics engine figures out how many associated actions have taken place, such as text messages or calls. So this is just one particular company using the logical method. And bam. It just shows what we could have had and what we should have had in this case. So it just frustrates me because it's very obvious that they're hiding something. They've edited this off, the footage. Now they're hiding narratives, thinking we're not going to notice that. We didn't get the full complete phone dumps. It's just everywhere you turn, it's a problem. And then the video I did yesterday, I believe it was, that shows that they are willing to remove surveillance cameras to hide criminal activity. And I believe that officer. There's not a doubt in my mind that he wasn't telling the truth. Not a doubt in my mind. Why else would he have went through all that trouble? You can say disgruntled worker all you want. This was a commander. This wasn't some little peon, PSO, little auxiliary officer. This was a commander who was being bumped up to lieutenant. These people are something else. Telling you, they are something else. And I'm not gonna get my foot off their neck. I'm gonna continue on. Well, that's really all I have. I wanted to show you what we should have had in a logical phone dump. Thanks, guys.